Hi friends, so here we are gonna see the integration based on beta function. So here we have to evaluate integration 0 to 2a x square root of 2ax minus x square dx. Now before solving this, we'll see the part of the integration and we'll decide the substitution. So here if you'll observe, then this form is matching with integration x raised to m b minus x raised to n whole raised to p dx. So if we'll compare, then this m is 2, this b should be constant, but here with b we have this x. So what I can do is I can take x common from both these terms, so that we'll get this integration as I equal to integration 0 to 2a x square. I can take this root x outside, and inside the root I can get 2a minus x. Now this x, root x is nothing but x raised to half, so this becomes I equal to integration 0 to 2a, this raised to half plus 2 is x raised to 5 by 2 and square root of 2a minus x dx. So now this integration is matching with this form. So in such form we put x raised to n as bt. So here I'll put x as 2at. So by substituting x as 2at, we'll evaluate this. So this becomes dx equals to 2a dt. So that is a def substitution for dx. Now let's see the limits. So limits for x were 0 to 2a. Now let's observe it for t. So when x is 0, so this becomes 0, 2a will go there, and 0 upon 2a is 0, so t is also 0. And when x is 2a, so that time 2a is equal to 2at, 2a, 2a cancel and t becomes 1. So this integration limits will change to 0 to 1. So hence we get I as integration 0 to 1, this x raised to 5 by 2 will become 2a raised to 5 by 2. Similarly, t raised to 5 by 2, because I am substituting x as 2at. This square root, that is nothing but raised to half term, will become 2a minus, this x is 2at whole raised to half, and this dx will become 2a dt. So by simplifying this, we will get 2 raised to 5 by 2, a raised to 5 by 2, which is a constant term. I'll keep it here only for calculation purpose. Next, this will become t raised to 5 by 2. From here I can take 2a common, so we'll get 2a raised to 1 by 2, and I can take it outside the bracket, so that becomes 2a raised to half 1 by 2, 1 minus t raised to 1 by 2, again 2a as it is dt. So if you'll see, then this 2 raised to 5 by 2, that is first term, this 2 raised to half, and this 2 will give us 2 raised to 5 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1, which is nothing but 6 by 2, 6 by 2 is 3, so 3 plus 1 is 4, which is nothing but 2 raised to 4. So these 3 terms will give us the value as 2 raised to 4. Next, similarly this a raised to 5 by 2, this a raised to 1 by 2, and this a term will give us a raised to 4 term. So we can get 2 raised to 4, that is 16, into a raised to 4 term, which is constant. I can take it outside the integration. So here we'll get I as 16 a raised to 4. And inside integration, let's see. So here, t raised to 5 by 2 remains, 1 minus t raised to half remains into dt. So t raised to 5 by 2 and 1 minus t raised to 1 by 2 dt. So hence, this term will give us the beta function, because it is matching with the definition of beta function, and that will become beta of 7 by 2 and 3 by 2. So by evaluating this, we'll get 16 a raised to 4 gamma 7 by 2 gamma 3 by 2 upon gamma 7 by 2 plus 3 by 2, that is 10 by 2, that is gamma 5. So here I'm using the property, that is beta m comma n, as gamma m gamma n upon gamma m plus n. So this term will give us 16 a raised to 4 5 by 2 3 by 2 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2. Again I am using the property, that is gamma m as m minus 1 gamma m minus 1. This 3 by 2 term will become 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2. Now gamma phi is nothing but 4 factorial. Here I am again using one more property, that is gamma m is nothing but m minus 1 factorial. So by doing this we'll get 16 a raised to 4, 5 threes are 15, so 15 as it is. This 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 4 twos, which is nothing but 2 raised to 4, will go in the denominator, 2 raised to 4. This 4 factorial is nothing but 24, and gamma half and gamma half in nothing but gamma half square, and gamma half is root pi, hence the square becomes pi. So here we'll get pi. So by solving all these terms, this 2 raised to 4, that is 16 and 16 cancel, we'll get 15 pi a raised to 4 upon 24. Now further solving this, we can get 3 5s are 15 upon 8 pi a raised to 4. And this is the value of integration. Thank you.